Florida is known as the Sunshine State for good reason, but it could just as easily be the Citrus State. Orange groves are a vital part of the economy, providing thousands of jobs and billions of dollars in revenue, but things are changing.
Sales are down substantially. Part of that is a supply issue. You know, Florida's production is down drastically. Seems like only 10 years ago we were harvesting over 200 million boxes of oranges. Now, this year, we'll be lucky to harvest 105 million boxes.
That drop in production is down to this tiny insect. It's called the Asian citrus psyllid, and it spreads a devastating disease known as citrus greening. It's the single biggest threat to growers in history and the reason that prices are rising. But it's not the only challenge growers are facing.
It's better for you anytime you're thirsty.
I'll be vitamin C in ya.
The days when orange juice was on every breakfast table are gone, thanks to rising prices and lifestyle changes. That juicy bag of oranges no longer seems to hold the appeal it used to.
We really like orange juice. It's very good and it's good for you, but the high sugar content is really why I don't drink as much of it as I used to when I was younger.
When you pick the oranges, they're small and they have that citrus greening disease, and they don't have the good Florida orange juice flavor.
But citrus greening remains the single biggest challenge for farmers across the state, despite strong overseas sales worth around $30 million. Resources are now being poured into research, but growing oranges is now an uncertain business. And for Florida's smaller orange growers, the risks are even greater. When demand goes down and citrus greening has the potential to wipe out your sole source of income, then there's a good chance you could go out of business entirely, which is why many here are turning to new crops. For fourth generation citrus farmer Dustin Lowe, that's meant turning to crops like blueberries. It's a decision he made 5 years ago and one he says helped save the family farm.
If we would have stayed in the citrus, like I said, I wouldn't be a full-time farmer. I'd still have to have a full-time job somewhere else and be a part-time farmer to be able to support my family.
The biggest challenge for the industry is getting production back up and prices down. But with no cure for citrus greening in sight, the next few years could be even tougher for one of Florida's most important crops. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, Dundee, Florida.